everyone. Today I'm going to talk to you guys about Mercy Otis Warren, one of the founding mothers of our nation. Mercy Otis Warren was a historian, a poet, a political playwright, and a commentator of the American Revolution. Her importance during this time was that she was a woman who lacked formal education, and yet she was very influential about women and men at her time. She was a political advocate, and she had very influential friends. Her exposure to politics, however, began from a very early age, as her father was an attorney of Massachusetts. Mercy Otis Warren also had the encouragement of all of the men in her life, pretty much, which was very important. During times when women were seen as not being qualified or really having a voice, much less a voice in politics, her father, her brother James Otis, and her later husband James Warren all encouraged her and aided as much as they could in her education and in voicing her opinions. Not only was her family important, but she also had political friends, which some of whom included the Adams, Abigail and John Adams, with whom she'd had correspondence with all the way through their death. Mercy Otis Warren was an influential woman of her times. She supported and advocated towards important causes of the revolution, of politics, and of domestic affairs. She was a supporter of the Boston Tea Party. She opposed women's lack of formal education, something which she herself thought that hindered her progress and her own voice. She used femininity in her favor. She gave domestic role of woman an important job. She supported freedom, equality, education, patriotism. Some of her works included supporting freedom of speech, freedom of press, freedom of trial, and restricting power of the executive branch, all of which later became part of the Bill of Rights. Some of her works, not only was she a poet, during her early time she wrote plays, she actually also wrote political satire. She was very strong opinionated, and she didn't fear this. She wrote political satire that was aimed towards Governor Thomas Hutchinson, which we can see the work right here called The Adulterer. And this was aimed towards him. It included no names, but they all knew it was about him. Some of her later, more serious works included A Recollection of the American Revolution, known as History of the Rise, Progress, and Termination of the American Revolution. This collection of her works was published in 1805 when she was 77 years old. As a writer and historian, a woman historian of her times, she was often criticized for not having a formal education and her validity of this. However, according to Patricia Tarantello, Warren actually used her femininity as a way to qualify herself as a historian. She quotes, "Because she was at home and less occupied in business of war, she was able to observe and record important events." Mercy Otis Warren also linked women's domestic role to war efforts. In fact, she said that women were more interested in war when loved ones were involved. She really voiced the woman's voice of the time. She was a mother and she was a wife of people that were all involved during the war. She was preoccupied for her father, she was preoccupied for her brother, for her husband, and for her three sons. She was often quoted to be so preoccupied with them that she even took a pseudonym at one point in her life to try and protect their reputation and their name. Thus, not only is she able to voice the American Revolution through her writing, satires, and poetry, but she also, through her own life experiences, was able to voice the real side of what women had to face during the American Revolution.